Hi, everybody. Today is March 23rd, 2013. This is an interesting article. Not just the fact that it's a vessel that burns coal, but they are allowed to dump the ash from that coal into Lake Michigan. Consent decree allows SS Badger to sail 2 more years. The SS Badger car ferry will be allowed to continue operating between Manawaka and Ludington, Michigan for the next 2 years, and allowed to keep dumping tons of coal ash overboard under a proposed agreement with federal authorities that was announced Friday. The agreement would require the Badger, the last remaining coal-fired ships on the Great Lakes, to reduce toxic ash pollution into the lake during the 2013 and 2014 seasons. The ship flushes nearly 4 tons of coal ash daily in a slurry into the lake during the shipping season, which runs from May 6 to October 13th. Dumping the ash has come under fire from environmental groups and others, including owners of the Lake Express Ferry between Milwaukee and Muskegon, Michigan. But the company and its backers say the 410-foot-long ship provides a vital link between the two states and is an economic boon for the Manawaka and Ludington areas. It began service in 1953. Lake Michigan Car Ferry, owner of the SS Badger, would pay a $25,000 civil penalty for violating water quality standards for mercury in 2012. According to a proposed consent decree between the company and the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency and the U.S. Justice Department, the agencies are accepting public comment for 30 days. The agreement represents a compromise, since Lake Michigan's car ferry had sought to continue dumping coal ash until 2017. The ferry was authorized to dump coal ash in a 2008 permit issued by the EPA. That permit has lapsed. It also pressed members of Congress for legislation that would have exempt the ship from meeting federal pollution limits, and it has also sought designation as a National Historic Landmark as a way to exempt the ship from making environmental upgrades. If federal authorities had ordered the ferry to stop the practice, the company could have appealed the action, either in the courts or to the EPA's Federal Appeals Board, which could have dragged out the dispute longer. This consent decree offers the fastest and most certain path available to EPA to stop the discharge of coal ash from the Badger into Lake Michigan, said Susan Hedman, administrator of the EPA's regional office in Chicago, in a statement. The enforcement agreement reduces the discharge of coal ash more quickly and with greater oversight than would have occurred during the appeal of a decision to issue or deny a permit, a process that often takes several years. Bob Maglitz, president of the ferry, said in a statement, "The resolution of this issue has taken far longer than we had hoped, but the end result has been worth the effort. This agreement will save the jobs of our 200-plus employees, as well as many other jobs in the states of Michigan and Wisconsin." Lake Express, the Badger's competitor, says the Badger reliance on antiquated technology has helped to lower its operating costs. "Our position is that they could comply," said Aaron Swartz, director of sales and marketing for Lake Express. "We felt they were delaying all along." The agreement between the Badger's owners and the federal agency doesn't specify how the ship will meet a prohibition against ash dumping in 2 years. But the Lake Michigan Car Ferry says it will store used ash on board. In a statement, the company said the agreement is the product of a lengthy process of working with the EPA to find the best solution, and includes the installation of a sophisticated ash retention system. The company received a $75,000 grant in 2011 from the State Division of Energy Services to explore the feasibility of using compressed natural gas or liquefied natural gas. Governor Scott Walker alluded to that grant on Friday when he issued a statement saying that he was pleased the EPA and the company found a reasonable solution that would keep the ship sailing while protecting the lake. But a critic of the Badger, U.S. Senator Dick Durbin of Illinois, was not pleased with Friday's agreement. "The SS Badger, the filthiest ship on the Great Lakes, has been given 2 more years to dump hundreds of tons of dangerous coal ash into Lake Michigan," Durbin said. The millions of people who live, work, and play in and around this beautiful lake should be outraged that this filthy ship would continue to operate. So I would remind him that this coal ash is also used, is it not, in fluoride. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep you up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.